I got a feeling that one of the guys that's going to make a play in this game is a Kamehameha graduate. Kamu, how's all this craziness been at the Super Bowl?
It's been a crazy week, man, you know. Just trying to block out all the distractions and stuff, but I mean, this is such a blessing, and it's truly just a once in a lifetime opportunity that I can't stop thinking about every day, every second. It's awesome just being in this.
Do you dream about that at this time? Did you as a young kid, you think, small kind of kid, I'm gonna play in the biggest game on the biggest stage one day?
I think, you know, growing up as a kid, I was always just, you know, just as any kid, you want to be something, and you look at all the athletes and stuff, and you want to be at the big stage, but you never really think like, okay, I'm gonna be here, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's kind of just one of those, that'd be awesome to be there, like. But then now that I'm here, I'm like, holy, this is for real. We're doing this. Let's go.
Talk to everybody about how you actually got here from Kamehameha to Eastern Illinois.
Yeah, so, I mean, I started playing football late, you know, like junior. I started my junior year. I didn't really have much offers. I didn't have any offers coming out until Dino Babers from Eastern Illinois came down and offered me. And, you know, I went there, which was a culture shock in itself. And then, you know, kind of just grinded it out there and ended up getting drafted in the sixth round. And the rest is history.
Now, what was the team that drafted you by?
Yeah, the Patriots.
So you get cut by the Patriots, end up coming to Philadelphia, find a place, making an impact, both as a linebacker and as a special teams player. Did you ever think that you would be called on in, you know, Jerry World?
Yeah.
If on national TV, millions of people. For one kick?
No, absolutely not. Definitely not. You talking about that Dallas
game? Did you practice ever before that?
No, never.
So you the kicker gets hurt.
Yeah.
And how did they even know you could kick?
Well, they asked me a couple weeks ago, like, hey, can you, like, if we, worst came to worst, could you kick a ball? And I was like, yeah, I played soccer my whole life, so yeah. And they're like, okay.
You practice? You practice? No practice?
No, they were just like, that's it. Like, no one really thought the kicker was going to get hurt ever. So they kind of went out there and...
Which makes you more nervous, facing Tom Brady or kicking that ball?
Honestly, neither. Like, it's just like, if you got it, you got it. You got to just send it sometimes and just, you know, just... I don't even know how to respond to that.
That's straight island boy right there. Oh, just give him cuz.
Just do it. You know what I mean? There's nothing to it.
Hey, listen. On a more serious note, all joking aside, you know, you're representing something certainly much bigger than yourself when you play. There's been so many great Polynesian players that have played in the National Football League. And every year when I do this, you know, for KHON, there's always a Hawaii connection somehow. You and Isaac are now the next in that line of guys. Do you feel like you have something on your shoulders or your responsibility to, you know, Hawaiian for all the young guys that are aspiring to be like you one day?
Oh, definitely. You know what I mean? Just like I was talking to my mom the other night, you know, all the support we're getting from back home, all the calls, all the texts, you know, it's honestly humbling, and just knowing that everyone's got your back. And growing up as that kid, you know, just seeing all these Hawaiian athletes and stuff, just wanting to be one of them and trying to aspire for these younger kids to do the same. It's we definitely got something to prove, and we got to go out and represent.
All right, Sunday, making a play, going to throw some shockers.
Oh, yeah, you know there's going to be a lot of that out there.
All right, bro. All right, mahalo, aloha.